I grew up here in Addis Ababa. There are a lot of cinema halls, and we used to copy posters of cinemas. And then that way I started making a drawing, and then I heard about Fine Arts School of Addis Ababa, and I joined the art school, and I studied there for 5 years. It was probably at the age of 15, you can say. If I don't work, I get sick. Every day I come to my studio and I start painting. There are some artists and who, whenever they have a mood to paint, they only paint. Otherwise, they don't paint. It's like life for me to make paintings. I love making paintings and I always feel happy. So I go to my studio, I start on one of the paintings, and then the mood will push me to do more and more, more and more. I simultaneously start painting on different canvases. But in my studio, I've got 6 or 7 spaces where I can paint at the same time. And then I roam from one painting. When I get tired, I go to the other painting. After graduating, I just started teaching at the art school. I started teaching drawing because drawing was a weakest part of the school. And then I started teaching painting, taught composition. Now I am teaching mostly conceptual drawing. Here you teach students to find themselves, to concentrate on their area of interest. So the student, before leaving art school, is going to be himself, to find himself. When I was studying, I was inclined to do more realistic works. And two teachers, they came from Russia. I attended their class, even though that it wasn't a regular class. I went to their class and attended because I had a desire to do realistic work. At the very early stage, everybody wants to do realistic work. And then I was dreaming of going exactly to St. Petersburg Academy of Art. And finally, scholarship came from Russia, went to Ukraine to study the language. And then after 1 year, I was sent to St. Petersburg Academy of Art, where I was dreaming. You cannot believe that the dream came true. You feel that you are an African. The thing is that you have a lot of friends, you know, Russian artists, friends. And they were always asking, Tadas, do you want to go back as a white Russian? Or you have to find yourself? And then I started from that moment on trying to find myself. Where I can find is, what, of course, an Ethiopian icon. You can even see in my graduation project that there is some kind of iconic structure. I'm not imitating what is in life. I am making my own composition. And the people in my canvas are thin and long, but they are born, they are like that. Lean, long, and with small hairs, like my paintings. You find it here in Ethiopia because a lot of poor people, they don't have the ability to get fat. So most of the people are here are very lean, unless very rich people, you know what you call.